I actually think that some changes in welfare were needed back in the 90s because you had some folks who were working hard and still poor. You had some folks who weren't working, and it was important for everybody to take responsibility for making an effort to find a job, to raise a family, to look after your children. What is true though is that after welfare reform, the problem was that we didn't give enough tools to people to get out of welfare. So we didn't give mothers enough child care. And if you're a single mom and you got to work, but now your child care is costing you as much as what you're earning on the job, but that's not a good thing. And that's why I think we've got to significantly expand the child credit so that mothers are getting more support. Transportation. This is even before gas prices went up. If it cost you about 2 hours or 3 hours salary just to get to the job, then you don't have enough left over to pay your bills if you have a job. So providing more assistance in terms of transportation and doing more to invest in mass transit so that people can get to and from jobs more conveniently, that's important. That's something that I want to make today. Expanding something called the Earned Income Tax Credit, which actually Ronald Reagan supported and Bill Clinton supported, and is a very smart program because what it does is, it says, look, you work, and if you're still below poverty, even though you're working, then the government, when you during tax time, you file something, you can actually get some money from the government to try to take you above poverty. We need to expand that to make work pay. I think that is a very important strategy. Healthcare. A lot of entry-level jobs don't have healthcare. And that puts an enormous burden on families, so it is important for us to make sure that we got a comprehensive universal health care plan so that you know you will have health care even if your employer doesn't offer you health care. As I said before, if your employer does offer you health care, then we're going to work with your employer to lower premiums by up to $2,500 per family per year. But if you don't have health care on the job, then what we're going to do is we are going to set up a system. You can get health care similar to health care. I was a member of Congress. And if you can't pay premiums, we won't subsidize you. And you won't be excluded from pre-existing conditions. And we'll emphasize prevention so that we don't have a disease care system, we've got a health care system. So our